Nama Om Vishnu Pare Krishna Prasai Bhutale Srimate Bhaktivedanta Swami Sinamne Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Prachayani Nirvisesa Swanyavadi Pasita De Satayani Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadara Srivasadi Gaura Bhaktavreda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare Navadwip Parikrama Ki Jai. When the Pandavas were in exile, they also came to Navadwip as we were traveling many places. Navadwip is one of the places they visited. So when they were in Ekachaka, there was a very powerful demon who was living there at that time. The demon was terrorizing people, who killed so many people. The demon has killed so many people. A stack of bones of the people he has eaten. So the villagers came together and made an arrangement that instead of the demon to just come and kill people randomly, they will make it a systematic way for the demon to take human beings as his food. So they arranged that every family will select one person, and the whole villagers, they will cook the food, and one person will be selected to take the food to the demon. The person who goes there will not come back. It is part of the food for the demon, Manasura. So when the Pandavas were in Ekachakra, they were staying with one Brahmana family. And at that time, it happened to be the turn for that Brahmana. They were just four, husband, wife, and two children. So one day, the wife of the Brahmana was crying. She was crying pitifully. Kunti Devi overheard their host crying so pathetically. So she went to her and asked, what is the problem? She said, my dear, don't worry about this, because it is not a problem that you can solve. So there's no need to ask for it. She said, no, tell me. There's no need telling you something you cannot do. What is it you telling you something you cannot do? You know the service I can request you to do. So why should I tell you? Don't worry about it. But Kunti Devi insisted, I would like to know what is the problem. After I sing for a long time, she was told about the calamity in the village. So Kunti Devi said, don't worry, I will help you. How can you help me? You are a woman, you are a visitor here, you are not part of our family. This is not something about a donation. They can ask you to give donation or something. One can do a charity for somebody, but this is not a charity one can do for someone else, because this requires life. Kunti Devi said, don't worry, I'll help you. You know, those my children, they are not ordinary human beings. They are demigods. So one of them will help you. The woman was not convinced. She said, pacifier, don't worry, I'll take care of it. At that time, the Pandavas were not in the house, but when they came back, Kunti Devi narrated the whole thing to them. See what has happened. Yudhishthira Maharaj was not happy. You know, we are preparing for a fight. We need all the brothers together. When you select one of them to go, and if he's killed, our strength is reduced. Kundi Devi says, it's okay. But Bhimsena was very happy. He was very happy because he has been fasting for a long time. So this is the time for me to break my fast. So he was happy, was jubilating. So the next day, the villagers, they brought up items and loaded it in the cart. Bhimsena was so happy. He was happy. He was running so he can get to the spot on time. So he got to where the demon lives. And he saw a stack of bones that the demon has eaten. Bhimsena was so angry with the demon. But anyway, let me have my feast first. So he packed the cart there and started eating the whole food. The demon waited, look at his time. The time for his food is passing. He was waiting, have they forgotten or what is happening? To his surprise, when he came out to check and he saw that the truck was there and a human being, not even demigod, a human being was there on the cart. And what's he doing? He's eating his food. The demon was very frustrated. He came and gave a heavy punch on Bhimsena at his back. Bhimsena just looked at him and continued with his eating. He ate everything, licked his fingers, washed his hands, and he jumped down from the the cart. And he looked at the demon, so what do you want? What will he want? This fight. So Bhimsena and this demon, they fought. Bhimsena, he take pride. He's just like a poet. He take pride in writing. He take pleasure in eating. A devotee take pleasure in chanting Hare Krishna mantra and serving Lord Krishna. Satyra, they take pleasure in fighting. That is where they get their bliss. So Bhimsena enjoyed himself. After a long time, he killed the demon. That was the end of Banasura. And then, while he was there in the fight with Banasura, Kunti Devi was feeling maybe Bhimsena is in danger. So she requested Arjun to go and see if he can help. He can help him. While Arjun was going, he was also thinking, by the time I'll get there, maybe it is late. So he sent one arrow, and that was a snake. By the time the snake got there, Banasura already killed. Now the snake has no service to do. So what to do? Arjun told him, stay there in the forest. Anytime somebody comes there, that will become your food also. So it's next day. When you go to Ekachakra, you will see this place. When Nityananda Prabhu came there, he used his earring to block the hole of the snake. Just came from there a few days ago, so I remember. I was telling the story there. I'm also requested to speak the first time here. So that was how Bhimsena killed Banasura in Ekachakra Dam. Hare Krishna.
Thank you for watching our videos. Be sure to subscribe to our channel. We publish new videos every day. And don't forget to like and share our channel.